Hello, folks. Welcome to tonight's game. This one's going to be good. Set their particular tempo. The center gets the pass. Fakes the shot. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. High post screen. So effective, that screen.
They move it into the front court. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside. That's a breakdown. That'll drive the coach bananas. That'll be to lose your hair. Trying to go inside.
The center takes the pass. And he'll kick it back outside. Trying to feed inside. On the dribble, gives it up. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
The power forward takes the feed. Fake. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Off the rim and no good. On the outside, he's got an open look for the shot. Dumps it in. Number one makes a great move to draw the foul. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
First shot, no good. He hits his second. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Jumps into the defender. Get it to the inside. Robs him of the ball. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Has a nice look at the basket. Puts up the tray. Gets it to go. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Trying to draw the foul. Number one makes the finger roll. There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there.
Puts it on the floor and up and under.
That's a good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
And he'll kick it back outside.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
Dickey's going to go up strong.
Oh, that's a terrific post play. Didn't waste any time attacking the basket.
The center with the ball. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Number 33 gets the ball. He shoots from downtown. They take it off the defensive glass.
Men have got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
On the outside. He shoots from the top of the key. Way off target. And a momentary look from three-point land. For two. Perfectly executed. looking for a good shot. On the inside, trying to draw some contact. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Way out on top, controlling the ball.
Let's take a look at that last basket. Up and inside.
He's going to muscle it on the inside.
What an explosive move to the goal. No wasted time. He had his mind made up. He was attacking the basket.
Goes for the steal down low, and he didn't get it.
I think he took a chance, and he lost, baby. Hey, one basket, Brad. If they can get some points here, the crowd will be extremely happy. Great play to take that to the basket.
With a stop here, there will be sheer pandemonium in the stand. Dick, when I see those types of things, I just get chilled.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Both teams are looking to get something going here.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Puts it up, looking for contact. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. There's a double team waiting there. He puts it in with contact and all. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Guys, he seemed very focused from the beginning. His game face was on, and he understands it's his time to perform. Let's send it back over to you.
That was a great, great effort right there, trying to play that passing lane, anticipating really well.
He looks at the hoop. Goes up for two, and he missed. The circle, they work it around the perimeter. Perfectly executed. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Gets the rebound.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
Number 44 with the fake. Executes the baby hook. Doesn't go. They work it around the perimeter from beyond the arc. He gets it to go. Pass down low. There's a drop step. And, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Playing for the steal in the post, and he didn't get it.
I thought he tried to make the spectacular play, but now he's embarrassed.
Big man spins down in the low block.
Does a great job getting the defensive player to lean one way and spin back the other.
Working it around the perimeter. Gave it up. Way out on top. Controlling the ball.
Look at that drive.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. Little Baryshnikov right there. You always were a dancer.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. From three-point range. Questionable shot selection there.
That I can guarantee you that he's not the guy. They want shooting the ball.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. And the ball goes out of bounds. Oh, and you talk about a happy group of fans. Listen to this crowd.
Oh, there's all kinds of people standing and cheering and going wacky.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Fakes it. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post-defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Double team now, bad angle.
High post screen, gonna use it.
Shot clock is dead. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Number 33 fakes the shot, looking for the foul. Up, easy one. With the jump hook and off the mark. Just hoping for the best. Comes up short. It's been a tight battle so far, Dick. Do you have a highlight of the half in your book?
Watch the great work here on the inside for the score. I expect both these teams to do more of the same and continue to pound the ball inside in the second half.
Well, it looks like the teams are just about set for the second half. Let's get back to the action. Focus player update, Dick Vitale, going into the second half. What does he need to do, you think?
I think I got to set some screens for him, a little double screens. He's a great shooter, but he's not getting the opportunity. I think his teammates have to screen for him.
Great shot block right there. They had some good movement on the offensive side.
And he missed.
Great anticipation defensively.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Here's a flash from the high post. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Both teams looking to get things going here. Looking for a good shot. Three. Off the rim and no good. He drains the bucket.
Instead of giving him that, use a foul.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Work it inside. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
He fakes the shot. He shoots from right in the circle. He doesn't get the hook. He grabs the rebound. This is what you're supposed to do down low. Go up strong.
I tell you, that was great post play. Clinic 101 on how to explode to the goal.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Jump hook from the low block.
I tell you, the jump hook, so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Big man spins down on the low block.
Does a great job getting the defensive player to lean one way and spin back the other.
Dickey's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
Number
Nice fake.
A little bit of a collision there, but no foul called there.
I think good call by the official. Not blowing the whistle. I think it's an excellent call.
On the outside.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Knocks it down.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set.
He takes the hard hack in the air, but he lays the ball in.
That's one you take for the team, Brad.
He goes to the line for the first time. Count it. Looking to move it around the perimeter.
Good athletic move. Very athletic. Got great athleticism.
The student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
Aren't they great, Brad? I love it.
Using his size with a power move.
Oh, what a power goal. Jump stop. Takes the ball with a goal. Strong.
Number one is eager and excited to compete.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions.
Here's the drop step in the low block.
Oh, he does a great job using his footwork to get over the top of the defensive player.
He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up. You get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
They can't stop this guy, Dick.
Want to give him a try, Brian?
If only my knees weren't aching. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
Goes up for two. Dickie's simply on fire.
Hey, call the fire department, baby. This one's burning up.
Applying pressure. For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Brad and Dick, the coaching staff told me before the game this is the one guy they need to get going quickly and early. They said when he gets hot, his entire team will follow suit, and they'll feel good about having the game in hand.
Thanks, Aaron.
I'll tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and on the move, and he does it exceptionally well.
Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first, initially, he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. The good rebounding position, a good block out, and that's essential in a post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
And he tries to spin away, draws the foul, and gets the basket.
He's into it. Wing baby, that's his name. I like that in a player.
With the free throw. He can't buy one. He cleans the glass. Working it around the perimeter. He looks for the bomb. Poor decision. He has no business taking that shot.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
He tries to knock down the three. Sinks it. Looks like the defender's a little bit tired out there.
This is no time to be tired. Get a sub if you need a break.
With the fake. Jumps in. He's making just terrible choices shooting the ball.
He's got to settle down, man. Settle that cat down.
With the catch. Nice. He gets the tough layup and a foul to go with it, Dick.
Hey, that was awesome, baby, with a capital A.
And we'll go to the free throw line. Sinks it. Dick, they're really going to have to monitor this because they've hit the bottom mentally. They're really going to be in some big, big trouble. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And he goes with a and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
That's an ill-advised shot.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Defense all over him here. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works. Hey, Brown, a stop here will definitely raise the decibel level. Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
For two, off the rim and no good. The defense is dictating their offense.
Hey, that's the way you draw it up, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up. He lets it fly. He gets that one to fall. Timeout's called. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
And I think she's right about that, Richie. We're about ready to hit the floor. It's a five-point ball game.
That's not a lot of points to be down with this much time, Brad.
He shoots from the top of the circle, and he's no good from downtown.
Roll it back, fellas. Look at that great defense right there. Not allowing them to make the turn.
Takes the pass in the paint. He gets the rejection. The point guard gets the ball. For the deuce, he can't get the bucket to fall. The point guard takes the pass. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Tries for two.
They have to foul to put them on the line and hope they miss.
That's a matter of clock management, isn't it, Dick?
Right, Brad. They have to foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Brad, I think they'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ballgame. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
Here's a double team. Well, Dick, the shots seem to be dropping for him right now.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. They're dropping, and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays.
And the clock stopped with a foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
I tell you, what an opportunity he's got right here. Because to me, this is a gift.
one.
Timeout's called on the floor. This is where the true players come to play. It's crunch time, baby.
We might see a little different look this time, Dick.
You never know what's coming, Brad.
It's a three-point deficit.
And that can change in a matter of seconds, baby. Hold on.
Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Rims out. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. At the line. Misses the front end of the one-and-one.
Timeout on the floor. It's a close one. The trigger fingers are getting itchy, baby. This one's too close to call.
They might try and surprise the opposition with a little change here, Dick.
That might not be a bad idea.
3 points is the difference.
That's right, so somebody better guard New York.
Goes up for two. Off the rim and no good. Our focus player update, our final one of the ball game, and he led his team to victory.
I tell you one thing, he really responded to the challenge, and that led them to the winner's circle.